Here at King County's Wastewater Treatment Division, we work around the clock to treat sewage from homes and businesses to protect you, your family, and the environment. We have over 400 miles of pipes that carry wastewater to our regional treatment plants. We collect wastewater from 17 cities and 17 sewer districts and serve about 1.7 million people in our area. We need to keep these pipes in good condition, but over time, corrosion can eat away at the pipe interiors. We regularly inspect these pipes and decide when it's time to repair or replace them. In some cases, we can restore the pipes instead of replacing them. Doing this reduces community impacts and essentially recycles the pipes. Let's look at one restoration technique for pipes called lining. Lining a pipe provides support and prevents further corrosion from wastewater and gases. This particular lining method requires crews to install a thin liner inside the pipe. Therefore, we plan this work during the dry season when there is less chance of the pipes filling up with sewage or stormwater. Sewer flows need to be sent around the work area before crews start working inside the pipe. To do this, we build a temporary bypass. This is a pipe which collects the wastewater at a point before or upstream of the work area. It carries the wastewater around the work area and discharges it back into the sewer pipe below or downstream of the work. Crews usually build the bypass pipe by putting together pipe segments and then run this pipe above ground. Detours may be needed if the bypass blocks roadways, bike lanes, trails, or sidewalks. Once the temporary bypass pipe is in place, pumps and generators are used to keep wastewater moving through the bypass pipe. During construction, King County's contractors work to reduce impacts to neighbors and the environment while the work is taking place. Contractors often use security fencing and screens to block off the work area, or use signs and flaggers to direct drivers, bikes, and pedestrians around the work. Erosion control is also used to keep dirt, water, or mud from leaving the work sites, and crews set up equipment to control odors from coming from the pipe. Once the sewer pipe is dry, crews can then clean the pipe walls and remove parts that are worn or damaged. To keep the workers in the pipe safe, fresh air is pumped into the pipe and foul air is removed. Crews then install the liner, adhering it to the interior pipe wall. Typically, this type of lining requires workers to use up to 3 access points, or maintenance holes, for access, odor control, and ventilation. Once the lining is done, crews remove support equipment from the pipe. Wastewater flows are then placed back into the newly lined pipe. Crews can then take apart and remove the bypass pipe and restore the area. Restoration may include repaving roads, replacing sidewalks or trails, as well as planting grass, trees, and shrubs. At King County, we're serving you, our community, and our environment with award-winning sewer service. Visit our website or our YouTube channel to see other ways we keep our regional wastewater system operating to protect our communities and our environment.